एक्चुअली हम लोग को अभी तक इतना व्यस्तता में वी डोंट फील सेफ एट ऑल. इवन व्हेन वी आर ट्रीटिंग पेशेंट्स ऑल डे 24 आवर्स, इट्स नॉट अबाउट द नाइट्स, इट्स नॉट अबाउट द डे, इट्स नॉट अबाउट फीमेल, इट्स नॉट अबाउट मेल. पीपल आर डिस्ट्रेस्ड. हॉस्पिटल इज ओपन 24/7. वी हैव वर्कड थ्रू 10 टू 15 इयर्स टू रीच एट दिस प्लेस एंड येट एवरी स्टेप वी हैव टू टेक वेरी carefully, because if we talk in any way, if we talk very nicely, they can come to us, people will blame us. If we talk not nicely and professionally, they will say we do not have empathy. So basically every system is against us right now. We are fighting for healthcare, we are fighting for everyone who works in a hospital, even nurses, even male doctors, even female doctors. And after this matter has come out, numerous cases of rape and abuse have come out of children, of girls in every state in India. So this is the condition of our country where we cannot take, we cannot choose one fight. Hum ek fight nahi choose kar sakte. Is state mein hua, is college mein hua, ladki ke saath hua, doctor ke saath hua. It's happening with everybody. It's such a big issue. I cannot even imagine. 365 days mein se 2 din hum kaam nahi karte hain. To logo ko lagta hai ki kitna bada hum log nuksan kar rahe hain. But ye cheez main bata do, we would rather treat our patient in our hospital for free than standing here in the sunlight and chanting slogans for no reason. We are fighting for something very big. We are fighting for dreams of children who can pursue their dreams without their parents thinking that they may die anytime. And even worse.
Time and again we have seen doctors on street, you know. But at the same time, how safe do you feel when you work in the workplace or in the hospital?
Honestly, what this situation that has brought up is the inadequacy of on-call duty rooms, unavailability of washrooms, different kinds of facilities which are available. Time and again, this issue, as you said, is keep coming up. But every time we see that the administration just promises a certain things and then eventually everything goes back. Now, because she was a doctor, because it happened in a hospital, this issue has come up. But it's not like doctors all over India are safe. It is happening everywhere. Administration has very less time to dedicate to all of this. None of the politicians I see coming up and actually providing support, giving us a statement which will make all of us feel safe. Every day for the past week, every girl, every female doctor has felt agitated. We are afraid. Our parents are calling us, telling us, jaldi ghar jao, jaldi ghar jao.
Very valid reason that not just for the doctors, but as far as females who have been working. And of course, they have a right to work, but also when it comes to safe environments, that also needs to be provided to them. We also have Shreya joining in. Shreya, as far as the Kolkata police is also concerned, there was expected to be a presser on part of them, exactly explaining what. Because now that the probe has been handed over to the CBI, the investigation, which now rests with the CBI, but the protest on hand, even when it comes to the vandalism, what are we getting to know with the number of arrests that has been made? Shreya. All right. In the meantime, the pictures that are coming in from different parts of the country, whether be it in the iconic Azad Maidan in Mumbai, there are pictures that are coming in from Thiruvananthapuram, from Kolkata, from Delhi as well. As far as protest marches that are being planned, IMA has already announced that there would be a 24-hour stir that will take place. Of course, when it comes to emergencies, that will operate. But this is when it comes to the protectors who are now needing protection. And at this point in time, when it comes to the unity that is now being seen on part of healthcare and medical professionals, coming at a time when this entire rape and murder case, unfortunately, that is also being politicized, it is the healthcare workers who are demanding justice. Shreya, if you can hear me, briefing on part of the police is also expected, especially when it comes to the vandalism and the number of arrests that has been made.
Well, of course, what we're hearing from police sources is that the number of arrests has gone up. The last update we had that 19 people have been arrested. Now, most probably, the number of arrestees has gone up and the Kolkata police has called for a press briefing. It would become more clear in some time. Now, while we're reporting live from Adjikar Medical College and Hospital, you can see that the CBI team have reached here. They have come with a forensic and digital team. team, they were carrying scanner machine. So this is the emergency building, as my VJ is trying to show you. Remember, this is the very building where in the fourth floor is the seminar hall where the incident has happened, the brutal rape and murder case has happened. And this is the same emergency building that has been vandalized by a mob on 14th of August. Now the CBI team have reached the place of occurrence. Remember, this is not the first time. 2 days previously, the CBI team have come to the place of occurrence to gather circumstantial evidences and everything. And once again, we see that CBI team reaches Adjikon Medical College and Hospital.
Right, but even when it comes to the vandalism that has taken place, of course, that becomes a different part of the investigation altogether. How has the court pulled up the police as well with the ongoing investigation?
Well, of course, we see Calcutta High Court have come down heavily on the role of the police and the state. Remember, there was a petition that was filed in Calcutta High Court seeking that the place of occurrence is completely right. sealed, and also asking for CCTV installation. Now, in right. that case, the state have told Calcutta High Court that a mob of 70,000 people have entered. Now, of course, Calcutta High Court questions the state machinery in this case.
All right. Please do continue to be with us, Shreya, and also let's get you the live updates that are now coming in on part of the investigation that is now being done by the CBI, because CBI taking over the case from the Kolkata police, and the team which has now reached the Arjikar hospital where this crime took place. The salutes that are there at the Kolkata hospital, of course, the teams that have been formed within the CBI would be when it comes to the assessment of